Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a guest design team project for Saw Crafters. And what I did today was alter her little lockbox. And this is what I came up with. I used the Prima. This is the Divine paper collection. You can get this in Saw's store. And on the top, I also use these flatback pearls that come from her store, and this is how they come. This is how many you get. Love this. These are so great because you can change them up any color that you want. I used a combination of her 9-row flowers, and you can see I've trimmed here and there and taken pieces off. I colored these with Lindy Stamp Gang Starburst in the Shabby Turbine Teal to get the color I wanted. Along with these flowers, I used some from my stash. These are Webster's, and I had, what did I do with the little, shoot. Oh, here it is. And then a long time ago, I got a swag of flowers for... It was like a $25 swag, and I ended up getting it for less than a dollar. And I cut everything off of it, and I just have all the little bits and pieces in a bag. And this is the center that I have here. I just colored it up and used some stickles on it and put it in one of those Webster's papers flowers. And then these are the ones from Saw's. Okay, that's about what I've used. These are the flatback pearls from Saw's. I took Made with Love heart from my sash. And then this little key that dangles, dangles on the side. And this little Believe were from Bunny Bow in Switzerland. Thank you, Manuela. I really appreciate these. And then I took one of the cutouts from the paper, these gorgeous little girls, and there is actually a recessed area, like a little frame when you put this all together on the front. So I put them in it, and then I covered it completely with 3D crystal lacquer, as I did the same thing with this little bird here that's flying on the front. Covered it in 3D crystal lacquer. Now you have to do one day and one the next so that you leave it sitting perfectly still for a long time because I had a thick coat on it. But you can see there, see how it shines? And this one, I'll get the, there we are. See how the light makes it shine? I love that look. This is the Bliss Arrow from Saw's store, which is covered in the Lindy's. I did it in the... Martha Stewart wedding cake acrylic. Nope, I take that back. This one I did in gesso, white gesso. Then I did it in some Lindy's. Then I put diamond stickles on it. Then I put more Lindy's and more of the peacock feathers distress ink over the top till I got the colors the way I like them. I glued down the flowers around the outside edge. I just cut papers from the paper collection that match, and I rough them up with my Tim Holtz distressor, so you can see the edges aren't smooth there by any means, and on the back and on the side. Now I have to tell you, I haven't worked a lot with mixed media products, so I used this Martha Stewart acrylic multi-surface satin acrylic craft paint, and I put it on, and then I tried to spray my Lindy's over it, and it just did not want to take. So probably I should have used white gesso with that, but I'm learning slowly, but I'm learning. So what I did, because I didn't like how it looked, was I took a piece of sandpaper and sanded it until the white came through here, and now I just love that look to it. Now, when you open the little lock box up, the whole inside, let me pull these out so you can see. The whole inside of the box has been covered with the cherub paper, and it's been painted and sprayed with Lindy's. And then I have an assortment You can see how many I have here. These are envelopes in the back, and then these are little tags in the front. And they just slip in here. They are 2.5 inch by 5, folded in the middle to give a nice little note card that you could attach to the top of a gift. Write a little sentiment on it and give to someone. Write some words of encouragement to yourself and put them back in here and pull them out at different times. But I just took different parts of the paper and made these. And then, like I said, I made these tiny little envelopes so that these will fit. Well, hopefully, what have I done here? Here we go. These will fit right inside. There we go. Of course, it never wants to do it when you're on camera, does it? And that's the way it is. This is a wonderful little project. What a great gift to give somebody. I haven't decided. I have a couple people in mind for this, and I haven't decided yet who I'm going to give it to. But I had a real stumbling block over this little box, trying to figure out what I wanted to do, how I wanted to alter it. So a friend told me just walk away from it for a little while and then come back. And when I did, it worked fine. It all came together just great then. So I hope you'll give this a try. These are very inexpensive boxes, and they would make perfect gifts to have on hand for someone. And you could fill the inside with a multitude of things, like bubble bath, the little bubble bath beads, or sachet would be beautiful in it. Anything at all to give someone a little treasure from your heart to theirs. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll have some clips of how I put it together. Some of my video was corrupted, so you're not going to get the whole thing. And then I'll have some still photos following. Be sure and check out Saw's store. She has beautiful wooden pieces like these arrows and this box and some trims and like the pearls and these flowers. So all kinds of things. Be sure and grab a cup of coffee if you haven't been there before, because it will take you a while to go through all the wonderful wood pieces that she's cut out. Thanks for joining me, everyone. Have a great crafty day. I hope you'll become a subscriber and leave me a comment. Bye-bye. I just wanted to give you a hint. If you're pre-cutting your pieces like I am here, it's really much better if you number your piece and number the side it goes on to. That way, as you're going along, if you get interrupted or if you have a multitude of sides or pieces that you're doing this way, you've already got a number corresponding, like there's 3 and there's 3, so you don't have any problem goobering it up, which I seem to do all the time. So just a hint for you.